All right, now let's move on to the 2022 elections. You are with the Nationalista Party.
That's correct.
You are a known supporter of President Duterte, but you're also known to be very close to Sara Duterte with the photos that surfaced recently. When Sara Duterte was in Manila, she was in your home in Makati. And I wanted to ask you, who will you support or who will the party support at this point?
Yes, we've already said, I think there are several parties who allied with the HNP in the last election. I ran for the Senate under the HNP banner together with the NP, the NUP, NPC, lahat kami ka-allied, no? At Lakas. So four parties went under HNP because if you remember, the party of president Mayor Duterte is not PDP Laban like the president's. Rather, she only has a regional party of HNP sa Davao. So yun ang aming banner party, as it were. And well, what can you say? I don't know. Are we allowed to say this on TV? Cojones! How did she come out with that statement?
So you don't, because many feel it could be a ploy. You don't believe that?
I doubt, knowing Mayor Inday, if she'll allow herself to be used in all these maneuverings. She's very straight up. And the fact that she opened with, I apologize to my mom, makes it very real to me at the very least.
Okay. Sources tell me that your brother, former Senator Bongbong Marcos, would most likely be the vice presidential candidate of Mayor Sara Duterte. So I know he should be answering this, but just quickly, is he even open in the first place to running for VP again?
Hey, my brother needs a job. He's been hanging around jobless for the past.
So he is open. I mean, after...
No, my brother is going to run in the next election. For we're not certain. As you said yourself, things are so volatile. He'll be honored to be the vice president or the tandem partner of Mayor Sara. However, right now it's such a mix-up. He's also perfectly happy to run for the Senate, if that's what's more likely. So my brother's really quite open. We just keep joking him that he needs to go do something.
Okay, because there was also a photo of you and your brother in the home of former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. And I wanted just to verify, a source tells me that no less than former President Arroyo has negotiated this tandem of Mayor Sara and your brother, Bongbong. Were there at least discussions on that?
There's so many rumors flying around. As you know, there's so many names that are being bandied about, also from Lakas, as vice presidentials. So everything's possible. But I suppose the most obvious thing is, if the Dutertes have the solid South, we are assumed to have the solid North, the Marcoses. So parang marriage made in heaven yan. So political wisdom says that you thought up the numbers, looks good. Looks like a really solid tandem.
But would you want that to happen? A Sara BBM tandem, frankly?
Why not? I think it'd be great. Be fun. I'm used to running with Sara. Sanay na ako sanay na ako sa mga motor kahit hindi ako marunong mag-motor. I'm used to it. We campaigned in 2019, so I'm perfectly comfortable and happy to join her. It's fun.
So it goes to show that you are not for your colleague, Senator Bongo, in case he does run for the president.
Well, I wouldn't say that because I also work happily with Senator Bongo. I don't like to take sides. Hindi naman ako taga-Davao na kailangan ganito o ganyan. I think it's possible to be friends with everyone. But clearly, Senator Bongo is a colleague in the chamber. But Mayor Sara was our boss in the campaign. Mm-hmm.
Some say that another Duterte or the country cannot take another 6 years of a Duterte. We're talking about an 11 trillion peso debt. I mean, frankly, you have foreign direct investments that are down. You have many saying that the Philippines will recover the last among Asian countries after COVID, and the market isn't doing too well. So you do have some critics saying that another Duterte may be bad for the economy and the country. What would you say to that?
I think many of the president's men will be bad for the country. But I personally feel that we need the Dutertes. It's their kind of warrior spirit that will get us through this war against COVID. We really need them around. I'm a big fan of the president. I am not necessarily in love with all of the cabinet. And I'm sure that if she becomes president, the mayor will have the same gumption, the same will, and the same ability to communicate with people so that during these difficult times, she will get her message across. She will unify us, and we will go on to recover.
So you're saying she's exactly like her father?
No, I don't think so. I think she's quite different. She's her own mind. Well, clearly, she's not a completely obedient daughter. And perhaps that's why I share that with her. There's some rebel kids here. It's a good match. She'll carry on with her father's determination and his fearlessness.
Okay, so just to close, what is the possibility of a Sara BBM tandem? I mean, of course, you do have the side of Gibot Yudoro saying that it's already him. There's also a side that wants Martin Romualdez, who's your relative. But you do have the BBM Sara. I mean, in circles that I've spoken to, it seems to be the strongest that I've been hearing for now.
Well, I wouldn't be presumptuous. I don't think the mayor has decided, but she certainly kept in touch and will remain friendly nevertheless and allied to the president, that for sure.
Okay, so just to make it clear, if Sara runs and asks your brother to run Bongbong, most likely he will run for VP. If Sara doesn't run, he will run for the Senate.
Yes,
is running for the presidency out, Senator Aimee?
No, it's not. For all intents and purposes, he has his own setup and he's running for president at the present time. But he's not officially declared, but he's walking around with the possibility of a top spot.
I see. So at least that's clear to your family. So he is, in effect, his preparations now is really running for the presidency. And then he's willing to adjust after.
Well, my brother is a fairly easygoing fellow, and I believe that he's happy to talk to everyone. And right now, people are saying that he should run for the presidency. Others say the vice presidency. There are others who say mag-senate ka na lang. Eh, sa kapatid ko, open naman siya. Ikot lang siya ng ikot. Sabi ko nga sa kanya, magpalakas na tayo.
But would you want him to run for the presidency?
No, I don't. The truth, as his manang, as his older sister, I think it's very, very difficult.
Okay, but you would want him to run for the vice presidency. You support that?
I'm a little bit like my brother. At this point in life, we've been through so much. It's all destiny. So we're open. If we're going to be the chosen ones, if you have that fortunate happenstance, just be ready, just work hard, have a recovery plan, make certain that you'll be able to leverage all the new technologies so that we get better in the future, so that we have a sustainable environment that is much healthier, so that we reward companies and people for health and the new normal, as it were, including all the kids who are involved in financial technologies, these new payment portals. Let's encourage all the baking moms. There's a lot to be done. There are green shoots in the economy that need to be encouraged.
On that note, Senator Aimee Marcos, I want to thank you so much for your time this morning. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right. Stay healthy and you take care. Thank you, Senator Aimee Marcos.
Yeah.